Did you know that you can use your turntable as a microphone? I have my Audio Technica turntable here. It's not even plugged in. You can see when I turn on the power, nothing happens. But I have the output of my phono cartridge connected to my mixer in the background. I have the gain turned up all the way. And what I'm going to do here is I'm going to lift this up and rest it on top of a little cardboard box here. That way, whatever sound vibrates the box will also vibrate the stylus on the phono cartridge. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to plug in the output of the mixer into the camera's microphone input, and I'm going to talk into the box, and you'll hear it using the stylus of the phono cartridge as a microphone.
Testing, 1, 2, 3, testing. I'm speaking right up to the box using the phono cartridge stylus as a microphone. Hopefully you can hear this. I just played back the first recording I made, and it worked much better than I expected. It actually sounds surprisingly good. The fidelity is actually not too bad, and it seems to pick up pretty well just using this little box to make my voice vibrate the box, which in turn vibrates the phono stylus. Now I'm going to try reproducing some music through this phono stylus microphone. I brought a little small radio here. I'm going to hold it up to the box and turn up the sound. That's how you can use a phono stylus on your turntable as a microphone.
Of course, you're probably wondering if the opposite is true, if you can use the phono stylus as a speaker. Well, the answer is yes, but not very well. I have the output of this little radio connected to what would normally be the output of the phono cartridge. Remember, on this turntable, I removed the internal preamp, so that's directly connected to the cartridge. And I have the radio turned up all the way, and I don't know if this will even pick up on camera, but you can just hear the faintest whisper of a sound coming out of this. Okay, this time I placed it more in the center of the box, and I tuned the radio to a talk station, so maybe voice would be a little more recognizable than music through this. And I set my camera on manual microphone gain, so I'm going to turn up the gain all the way, and maybe you'll be able to hear it. So yes, technically it does work in reverse, but barely. It works much better as a microphone than as a speaker. And it makes sense that it would be barely audible, because if you look in the specifications listed on the back of some of the early hi-fi stereo LPs, they mention all the equipment they used, and they would say something like a 70-watt amplifier on the cutter that would cut the master record, while this is putting out maybe 100 milliwatts at best out of its headphone jack. So maybe if I connected this to a speaker amplifier, it would produce better results, but I don't want to burn out my phono cartridge trying to use it that way. So if you want to do that, do it at your own risk.